From Television City in Hollywood, it's Card Sharks. Here's the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubanks.
Ah, thank you. Thank you, Gene Wood. Thank you very much. And hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. We're glad you could join us today. We have lots of money to give away and a very exciting game with two nice people. Before we get going, though, I want you to meet our two lovely dealers. Here they come. This is Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams.
Good
morning, ladies. Why don't we deal the cards just as if where we left off last time? Could you do that for me? Susanna will be dealing the red cards to our returning champion, while Lacey deals out the blue cards on the lower level to our challenger. And we're going to pick it up from where we left off last time. We left off with these two nice people. Let's bring the card sharks in here now. Hi, champ. Boy. Let me ask you a question. You brought Bob, your husband, when you were winning $10,950. Uh-huh. Now you've got $16,750. Did you bring him back today?
Yeah, he's here.
Boy, he came back again.
Uh-huh. He wants more money.
He's still wearing his suit. Is that the only suit he owns?
I guess
so. He's going to have another one.
He's going to have somebody to buy another one now. Same tie, even. Bob, what's the matter with you? Oh, Sandy. Tell us about Sandy.
I'm Sandy Nakata. I was born and raised in Honolulu, Hawaii, and right now I live with Bob in El Segundo, California.
You don't sound so excited about it. I mean, he's a nice man, right?
Yeah, he's real nice.
He's a good husband, right?
Oh, sure.
He's a great lover, right?
My mom said never lie. I'll just take the fifth.
I see. Okay. And our challenger. Hello, Elias.
Hi there. Oh, I'm Elias Jacob.
Did I wake you? I'm really sorry.
I'm dreaming about this guy.
No, you're worried about Bob.
Yeah, I'm Elias Jacob. I'm from New York originally, but out here 18 years. I'm working as a driver, and I just love it out here.
Well, it's nice to have you back. Okay, remember, we're going to pick it up from where we left off last time. And where we left off last time, we were in the middle of game number one, right? Game number one, and this was our third high-low question. So good luck to the two of you. Remember, the first player to win two games wins the championship and goes on to play the big money cards. Here's the first question of the day. Game number one, third high-low question. Sandy, we surveyed 100 women married less than 2 years. We asked them, have you ever seriously considered divorcing your husband? How many married women admitted that they had?
Oh, let me tell you, the first year is the toughest.
That's right. You cried through your honeymoon, didn't you?
Yeah. 2 weeks later, 1 year later, oh.
You mean you seriously considered divorcing old Bob?
Yeah. And I was mad at him, of course. Yeah.
You were mad at him.
Yeah.
I see. Okay. How many married women admitted they have, other than you?
It's going to be a fairly high number. Not too high, so I think it's 56.
56 out of 100. Elias, higher or lower than that?
Boy, that's a heck. That's a tough question, but it's true what she said. A lot of them do think about it. I'm going to go just a tad lower.
A tad lower. All right. The actual number of women married less than 2 years who have seriously considered divorcing their husband is 19. It was
lower. All right.
Okay, Elias, when last we left off, you had the jack. You want to keep it?
Yeah, I'm going to go lower.
Lower than the jack. Let's find out. It is a queen. That means that Sandy gets a free shot at the card. Sandy, you have to play off the seven. If it's higher, you win game number one. It is. Whoa. So, add another $100 to your total. Game number one goes to Sandy. We will begin game number two of this match between these two nice people, and we come back after this. See you in just a moment. We have returned, and we're ready to begin game number two. Sandy won the first game, another $100. First player to win two games goes on to play the big money cards. And let's begin this game with Elias this time. Elias?
Okay.
This is a topical question, my friend. The Internal Revenue Service offers rewards for tips about tax cheaters. So we surveyed 100 people, and we asked them, for a $10,000 reward, would you turn a friend into the IRS? How many people admitted that they would turn in a friend?
That's a terrific question.
Thank you. I wrote that one.
Jeez, that's tough. No, I don't think you turn in a friend. I think the number would be comparatively low. Friendship means an awful lot, even if they are cheating. And I think everybody does cheat on their income tax. I think the government...
Wait a minute.
Well, I think the government forces
don't
you to do it sometimes.
Don't include me in this, okay?
I know, but they do. Okay, I'm going to say the number is comparatively low, so I'm going to say about 18.
18 out of 100 people admitted they would turn in a friend. Sandy?
I agree. I wouldn't want to turn in a friend, but $10,000. I mean, I wouldn't, but I'm sure a lot of people would be tempted to.
So?
So I think it's going to be a little bit higher.
Oh, I hope not. Okay.
I know.
Actual number of people who would turn in a friend to the IRS is 19. Just a little higher, indeed. Only by one. The lady is good. All right, Sandy, here it is. This is your card. It's a jack.
I'm going to keep it and go lower.
Lower than the jack. It's a four. Higher than the four. Got a queen. Lower than the queen, it's a
queen. Oh,
right back to the jack you go. Thought
I'm
she had
saved,
it. Elias.
Elias.
You ready?
Okay, ready.
Got to play this one. You can't change it. It's a nine.
Okay, I'm going to go lower.
Lower than the nine. Five.
Okay, I'm going to go higher.
Higher than the five. Nine.
I'm going to freeze.
Freeze on the nine. Going to protect this position if he wins the next high-low question. He'll have a chance to change
that
card. Sandy. We surveyed 100 men. We asked them, if you could live an extra 5 years by giving up sex forever, would you do it? How many men said that they would?
I think that's going to be a very low number.
Wait a minute. If Bob could live an extra 5 years by giving up sex, would he do
would
it?
He would give it up.
He would.
He's an exception, yeah.
How many men said they would? Now, they have to give up sex forever.
Forever.
They live an extra 5 years.
Oh, I think that's going to be a very low number. I say 35.
You think it's going to be a low number? You think 35?
Yeah.
Elias, what do you think?
I have to disagree with that. I really do. I don't think a man would give up sex to live five more years. I think it's going to be lower.
You think it's going to be lower than that?
Yeah.
I disagree. I really do. If someone would say, you can live an extra 5 years of your life if you give up sex forever, I would do it in a minute, because that's 5 years of your life.
But it depends on their age. If
I mean, there's more to life than sex, Elias. I mean, there's hair.
Oh, that's a low, dirty trick.
No, I'm talking about me.
Oh, no, you weren't.
Yes,
that's
I am. Actual number of men who would give up sex to live an extra 5 years is... 23. You're right.
Oh,
it was low.
All right.
I would. I really would. 5 years of your life. You want to change the nine?
Please.
Well, I'm talking about the other thing. Oh, okay. Here we go. The nine is now four.
Okay. Lower.
Higher than the four. It's a six.
I'm going to freeze.
Freeze. He'll
freeze
right there. He's got
myself.
A good lead in this game. He keeps Sandy away from the cards. Oh. Good strategy. Let's see if it works. Let's try another question. You okay?
You know, God only made a few perfect heads, and the rest he covered with hair.
One for the fat guy and one for the contestant. Next question. This is for you, Elias.
Okay.
We surveyed 100 garbage men, and we asked them, have you ever actually found money in someone's trash? How many garbage men said that they have?
Yeah, you know, you read about that a lot in the paper. There's a lot of garbage men who are honest enough when they find something that they turn it in.
A lot of garbage in the paper, too.
Yeah, but I don't think the number is very high. I would say about 31.
31 out of 100 garbage men said they have. Sandy?
It's so hard to find money. I mean, it's so small, and there's so much trash. I think it's even lower.
You think it's lower than
that?
Yeah. Actual number of garbage men who have found money in someone's trash is... 51, not lower, it was higher. Now, see, the strategy may have worked for you. Froze on the six, you can change it. Now it's a deuce.
Higher!
Of course,
higher.
Here's game number two.
All right. All right. All right.
Way to go. Now, you each have a game. So, you know the first player to win two games. That means we have to play our tiebreaker game. And this time, Susanna's going to deal out three cards in the tiebreaker game. We'll have a maximum of only three high-low questions. Winner of this game is the champ, plays for the big money. Good luck to both of you. Sandy. Sandy, we surveyed 100 top fashion models. We asked them, if you met the man of your dreams, but he insisted that you give up your career, would you? How many top models would give up their career for the man of their dreams?
Oh, I think that's going to be a low number. He's such an idiot to say that, because he should respect her wishes and what she wants, her goals. Yeah, he's going to stifle her if he tells her that. So I say it would be 18.
18 out of 100. Elias.
Okay, give me that again.
How many top models would give up their career for the man of their dreams?
If it's the man of their dreams, yes, I think it might be a little bit higher. I think it would, because...
Might be higher than that.
If it's the man of their dreams, they would.
Well, let's see. The actual number of models who would give up their career for the man of their dreams is... 38. You're right, Elias.
Oh, right.
It was higher.
Okay. Oh,
you know what I'm interested in? Could that possibly be the man of your dreams if he asked you to give up your career?
That's a good question.
Thank
Very
you.
Good question. Good, Bob.
I just
good.
Asked you a question. I mean, would you give up your career for the man of your dreams?
It depends on how much money the man of my dreams has. I mean,
okay.
If he made more than I did, possibly.
No one makes more money than you do.
Oh, really?
Elias, this is it. It's a 7. You can change it.
Please change that card.
Let's see. The 7 now becomes a 5.
All right. Higher
than the 5. Your card is a queen.
Lower!
For the
lower!
Championship, if it's lower than the queen, no! Oh, my gosh. You all right, Elias?
You have a paramedic on this guy?
Yeah, we have a paramedic. We got more than one. Okay, Sandy, free shot. Jack.
Lower
than the jack. 10.
Lower!
For the championship, if it's lower, yeah! Yes, she is. Let me tell you something. She may be tough, but this man just hugged Sandy and said, God bless you, sweetheart. You're a nice man. You're really
Thank you. I had a lot
guy.
Of fun being here.
Thank
Believe
you,
me.
$100 is a nice
Bye-bye,
gift.
Sir.
To see you
Good
again.
See you.
Come here. Back in just a moment to let her play the big money cards. Don't go away. Welcome back. Well, oh, heck. This is kind of a sad time for all of us here on Card Sharks because the CBS rules say that you can only play the big money cards 5 times. So this will be your 5th time over there. And that means we'll have to say goodbye to you after this. What are you going to do with some of this money?
Well, my grandparents are celebrating their 50th wedding anniversary this year. So I called them up and then... I told them I wanted to send them to the Orient, but they don't want to go. They want to come and see me.
Well, here they come.
Yeah,
then.
They're coming.
That's good.
It's summer. Yay.
Let's win some more money so you can bring the whole island over if you want
yeah.
to, okay? You know how to do this, don't you? Sure. We're going to start you off in the bottom row there with new money, betting money, $200. You bet your way across there by calling off high and low. When you get to the next row up there, we'll give you another $400. And again, you bet your way across. Remember, minimum bets are $50 each time. Except when you get up there to the top row at that time, you must bet at least half of your dollars. And also don't forget that you'll have a chance to change one card per line by choosing one of the spare cards that Lacey is dealing out right now. We're going to miss you.
I'm going to miss you too.
Good luck to you. Give her $200 and here we go. All right, Sandy, this is it. This is the 9.
Change that card, number 1.
Number 1. The 9 now becomes a 5.
Oh, $100.
100 higher than the 5. It's a 4. You still got $100, though.
Oh, $100 higher.
100 higher than the 4. It's an 8.
Yeah,
now you got 200. All of it lower than the ace. Your card's a jack. And now you got 400. Give you another 400 up here. So now you have $800, and that's your base.
$600 lower.
600 lower than the jack. It's an 8. Yes.
Number 3,
the 8 now becomes a king. And you got 1,400.
1,300 lower.
1,300 lower than the king. It's a queen. 2,700.
$2,000 lower.
$2,000 lower than the queen. Yes. $4,700, the 9.
And you can... Number 2.
The 9 now is an 8.
Lower than the ace.
There you go.
$1,350 is what you win. You're a lucky man. Hang on to this lady. We'll be back to meet two new players on Card Sharks right after this. And now, as I promised, let's meet two new contestants on Card Sharks, and here they are.
Hi, Bob.
Hello, Frank and Mary Beth. How are you,
Frank? How are you? Fine. How are you doing, Bob?
Good. What do you do?
Well, I'm originally from Dobbs Ferry, New York. I wait tables at night, and I deliver strippograms during the day.
Wait a minute. Time out. You do what?
Strippograms.
You mean you deliver telegrams that have no clothes on?
I deliver telegrams and I take my clothes off.
No, I'm not going to tell him to do one. Just deal a card, Susanna. That's disgusting, Frank.
It's a living, Bob.
How much do you make?
Enough.
Wait a minute. Tell me about how much. No kidding.
Yeah.
What I make.
Get out of here.
Yeah. Well, it's nice to have you here.
Thank
anyway.
You. It's good to be
Mary
here.
Mary Beth, how are you?
Hi, Bob. How are you?
You ever stood next to a stripper?
No, but I'm enjoying every minute of it.
Yeah,
I am. You bet.
Is that right? Hey, what about Mary Beth?
Hi, I'm from Indianapolis, Indiana,
okay.
And I am a cheerleading advisor there, and I live 5 minutes from the Indianapolis Motor Speedway.
Well, wonderful.
So, we're waiting for May. That's
zoom, zoom, zoom.
That's right.
Nice to have you. You guys got the cards?
We sure did.
Sure
wonderful.
Did.
Susanna's going to deal out those cards. Stay over there where you belong, Susanna. And she'll deal out those cards, and let's start this game right now. First question, and it goes to Frank. Remember, first player to win two games wins the championship, goes on to play for the big money. Frank. We surveyed 100 men. We asked them, have you ever decided not to buy a girly magazine because you couldn't face the woman at the cash register? How many men admitted that they have decided not to buy the magazine?
You know, Bob, that's funny because I've done that quite often.
Wait a minute. You take your clothes off and you don't want to buy a girly magazine?
Well, come on. You know, she doesn't know who I am or what I'm doing. I go over there, look at her, I say, yeah, I'd like to buy it, but, you know, wonder what she's going to think of me. I do have some morals. Some. How many have refused to buy? I'm going to say that's going to be a median kind of number, maybe 40.
40 out of 100. Mary Beth, higher or lower than
guys,
that?
Guys, nowadays, I don't think they have any morals left. I mean, us women, I mean, it's just like we have to, you know, say no all the time, and we get sick of it. You know, why?
I've had to say no.
Well, so am I, but that doesn't matter.
I never said no.
I just think a guy is just not going to be embarrassed to go up and say, boom, there it is, I want it. So I'm
yeah, but back to the magazines.
That's right.
Okay.
I'm going to think they're going to go up, they're going to get it. So I'm going to say it's a higher number.
Higher number.
That's right.
Yeah. Actual number of men who decided not to buy a magazine is 26. Wasn't higher, it was lower. That means that Frank, you have control of our cards. You can change this card if you want to. Frank, it's a
I'm
king.
I'm going to keep it. I'm going to go lower.
Lower than the king. Your card is a 10. Player freeze.
Freeze
on the 10. Starting off kind of conservative. You'll freeze right there. Keeps Mary Beth away from the cards. We'll pause for these words, and we'll be right back in just a moment. So there we are. Time for us to go for today. We've had a good time. Hope you have, too. Until next time, I'm Bob Eubanks. For Susanna Williams, Lacey Pemberton, Gene Wood, and the whole gang, saying thanks for watching our show, and we'll see you next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye, everybody.
Some of our departing contestants will receive a travel cosmetic bag. And now, perfect polished nails in seconds. Just press on Lee, press on nails. Now in a rainbow array of fashion color. A gift certificate with which you may select items from Carol Wright Gifts. Look for Carol Wright in your mailbox. A travel alarm and milk bone. Help your dog crunch away plaque and food particles for cleaner teeth, fresher breath naturally. Get milk bone dog biscuits. A calculator and scrub-free Pine Fresh all-purpose cleaner. It cleans without scrubbing, scratching, or rinsing, and it deodorizes with a Pine Fresh scent. High-energy Conair phone. The 80s look in popular fashion colors. Conair phone. The quality line in telecommunications. A cookbook and success. The boiling bag rice cooks in 10 minutes. No measuring, no mess. Perfect every time. Once you switch to success, nothing else will do. And the member of our studio audience will receive Gibson's food freezer with bullwhip shelves. Glide-out basket, adjustable cold control and frost-clear system, no frost on containers, packages, or freezer walls.
How do you like your feud? With the friendly lip service of Richard Dawson or the traditional stylings of Ray Combs. Kissy, no kissy, kissy, no kissy, kissy, no kissy. You decide with a full hour of The Feud coming up next, only on Game Show Network.
Here they are.